Good morning from the Garden Tomb. This is where Jesus was buried, and this is where he actually resurrected from. We're about to celebrate the death, the burial, and the resurrection of Jesus in just about a week from now. And I just wanted you to know that the tomb is empty right here in Jerusalem. And why? I would prefer that you see for yourself. Jesus Christ declared with power to be Son of God by the resurrection from the dead. The resurrection is a powerful declaration of his messiahship, sonship, and his deity. So I just wanted to reassure all of those people who are still in doubt whether Christ indeed resurrected, not only that he resurrected, and not only that the tomb is empty. This is the most important and the most powerful symbol or token or display of his lordship. He defeated death, he resurrected. And if you read in John chapter 14, verse 24, this is something that always I'm being reminded of, that a grain must die first in order to sprout. And so he resurrected from the dead, and he's seated right now at the right hand of God the Father. And it is so you and I will have life and life in abundance. So from the Garden Tomb here in Jerusalem, where the tomb is still empty, I want to wish all of you a happy resurrection day, probably a week and a half from today. I will be giving a message on why Jesus had to die. The title of the message is "It is a Must," and we'll take a look at the scriptures talking about all the scriptures that had to be fulfilled, and we'll try and understand, was the crucifixion of Jesus an accident, could it be avoided, or was it a must? Was it something that God had to do because of things that happened, or was it the perfect will of God the Father? So stay tuned. So from the Garden Tomb here in Jerusalem, God bless you and shalom. Bye-bye.